सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमास्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृत वंदे भगवन्तं पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणुजाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरुहि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। आम्नायान्ति संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। इंट्रोडक्शन टू दी 60th सूत्र इन दी थर्ड पाद ऑफ दी थर्ड अध्याय से पूर्व अहंग्रह उपास्ती नाम विकल्पेन एव अनुष्ठेयत्वम् अभाणी। वी हैव सीन दिस जस्ट एज अ रीकैप फॉर दी संगति। Earlier, what was stated and established by the Siddhanti is the Vikalpa in Ahangra Upasana, Upasti or Upasana. So, Ahangra Upasana where in Hridayakasha, Prana, Aditya, Ityadi, which are seen as Paramatma, there one has Aham Bhava. I am that very Prana. Who is Paramatma? That is Ahangra Upasana. So when there are multiple Ahangra Upasanas with various methodologies which result in the same phala, which give the same result, which give the same phala, the sadhaka can pick one and stay to it, Upasaka. Said the Siddhanti, this is what was established by him. Similarly, he says, tadvad upasthitva avisheshat. Because the following pratika upasanas are also upasanas, similar to ahangra upasanas, pratika upasthinam api vikalpineva anushthiyattvam syad. Iti drishtanta sangatya yadamaha. Purvapakshi is taking cue from Siddhanti and extending that logic to the other upasanas such as pratika upasanas. Pratika upasanas, in the pratika you have the devata buddhi or the upasya buddhi. Upasya can be omkara also. So omkara or udgita, udgita upasita. So you see omkara itself as udgita, which is an avayava of udgita. And the latter Udgita is itself an avayava or bhaga, part of Sama Mantra, whether it is Pancha Bhaktika or Sapta Bhaktika. So in the Pratika such as Salagrama Vishnu Buddhi, such as Shivalinga Shiva Buddhi, this is Pratika Upasana. Each of these have different results. Not all devatas can give you all sorts of results, even in smartha karma. Jokingly, Swamiji was saying that a person goes to, I think in north, very famous, Shitila Devi. So he goes there, she is basically a deity who takes away, Devi who takes away diseases, most kinds of diseases. So people go and pray for mukti from diseases. So jokingly the Swamiji said, someone went and asked for Mercedes car to that Devi. And what is her vehicle? She rides a donkey. Her vehicle is a donkey and you want her to bless you with a Mercedes car. It won't work. It was on a lighter side, But you get the idea. It is like, there are people who, there is a sampradaya somewhere in Maharashtra or elsewhere also where unmarried girls who want to get married, they go to Hanuman and pray. Hanuman is a akhanda brahmachari, naishthika brahmachari. So it's very odd. If he is capable of giving you, he'll give you. If the deity is capable of blessing, there is an area of area in which the deity works. Just give me a moment, please. Sorry. Please excuse my sore throat today. So, whatever is the area operation of the deity, geographically also it will work only in that area. Now, these Vaidika devatas, they don't have a particular temple or something where you are worshipping. You are invoking that Lord in a particular form. And when the Devata or Paramatma is invoked in a particular form, in a form of a Devata, and the Upasana is mentioned the way it has to be done by the Shruti, if the Upasaka does it in that manner, he'll get only that kind of phala which is discussed there. Nothing more, nothing less. Less is possible if there are shortcomings in the Upasana. So the anugraha of the Upasya Devata which gives phala is possible only to the extent that the Upasana, Shravata Upasana discusses. That being the case, across Upasanas there are phala Vedas. If there are phala Vedas and they are kamya, meaning the result is desired by the Upasaka. And these results vary, desires vary. A single Upasaka may have multiple desires. So he has to do multiple Upasanas because not a single Upasana will give all the desired results. That being the case, Siddhanti has a perspective as to this is different from the Ahangra Upasana, where the phala is same across various Upasanas. There you can stick to one. But in the case of Pratika Upasanas, Kamya Upasanas, you have to do all the Upasanas for which the results discussed are desirable for you. So that is the difference between the two. However, Purva Pakshi is using the earlier Adhikarana as an example and extending it to the Pratika Upasanas also from Ahangra Upasanas. Therefore, there is Drishtanta Sangati. The example is the earlier Adhikarana and the exemplified is the following. And thereby, now we look at Kamya Adhikaranam. Kamyastu yatha kamam samuchiran nava purva hetvabhavat. Kamyastu yatha kamam samuchiran nava purva hetvabhavat. So kamyaha tu yatha kamam samuchiran na va पूर्व हेतु हेत्वभावात्, इट्स अ सिंगल समासा, पूर्व हेत्वभावात्। सो काम्याः, काम्याः आर व्हाट दी काम, काम्या इज दी कर्मणि व्युत्पत्ति, सो इट इज दी डिजायर्ड, डिजायरेबल और डिजायर्ड, व्हाट इज डिजायर्ड? So kamyaha are multiple desirable things. So desired are many. So two, on the other hand, as compared to the ahangra upasanas, these pratika upasanas or kamya upasanas should be done yatha kamam. Yatha kamam means kamam anatikramya. That is the vyutpatti of the avyayi bhava samasa there. So not transgressing, literally what it means is not transgressing the kama. So you can do the upasana in keeping with the kama, which the upasana is capable of giving as a phala. So as many kamas are there, so many results are promised in the upasanas, and those many one can follow. So samuchaya is possible, samuchiran. समुच्चय एंड वन में कंबाइन देम एज पर द डिजायर्स यथा कामम समुच्चय एंड इफ यू वांट द फल यू वांट टू राइट नाउ देन यू कंबाइन द टू उपास कंबाइन इन सेंस यू कैन डू टुगेदर यू कैन डू देम टुगेदर एट द सेम टाइम वन आफ्टर द अदर ऑन द सेम डे ऑल दैट इज पॉसिबल नवा और नवा मीनिंग इफ यू डू नॉट वांट टू डू देम टुगेदर You want to get one phala and then go to the next one, that is also fine. You can sequence them also. So, samuchiren, samuchiren, nava samuchiren. Or, one may not do multiple upasanas, one may stick to one. Why? Purva hetu abhavat. Purva hetu nam abhavat. Whatever hetus were given in the earlier adhikarana by the Siddhanti, those are missing here. Because what was said earlier, avishishta phalatva, the avishishta phala, vedya sakshatkara akhya abhinna phalatva ityartha was said by the Siddhanti. Result of the ahangra upasanas across the board are same. But here, in the pratika upasanas, kamya upasanas, the results are different. So, purva hetu abhavat. The earlier hetu is not there. I use a plural here, but it should be single one. Single hetu was given. Purva hetu abhavat is purva hetoho abhavat. Atra purva pakshe vrihadishu iva anushthana niyama asiddhihi. Purva pakshi says there is no niyama as to the niyama is not established the way it is seen in vrihi adi ityadi karma kanda. In karma kanda, vrihi has to be used, then vrihi only has to be used as dravya. You cannot use something else. So there you see anushthana niyama. How a particular karma has to be done. Which dravya should be used. What should be offered to which devata. So yakshanu rupa. Balihi. So, the Bali is in keeping with the Yaksha, the Devata, in Karma Kanda. That we can apply here also, but it is not Bali, the Phala. The Phala is in keeping with the Upasana. So, Phala is limited. If one wants more limited Phalas, then one has to do as many Kamya Karmas, Kamya Upasanas. पूर्व पक्षी से व्रीहादिषु इव अनुष्ठान नियम सिद्धि व्रीहादिषु इव अनुष्ठान नियम सिद्धि सॉरी नॉट असिद्धि सिद्धि सो द पूर्व पक्षी सेइंग व्रीहादिषु इव द वे इट इज सेड इन द कर्मकांड व्हाट शुड बी यूज अनुष्ठान नियम इज देयर इन काम्य उपासनाज आल्सो सिद्धांते फलवशाद अनियम इति फलभेद देर इज नो सच नियम दैट यू हैव टू फॉलो ओनली वन वाई सी इन दी पूर्व पक्ष व्रीहादिशु मीन्स वेर व्रीहि हैज टू ऑफर्ड व्रीहे अलोन हैज टू बी ऑफर्ड सो यू कैनॉट ऑफर समथिंग एल्स सो आई डोंट हैव व्रीहि टुडे लेट मी ऑफर दधि दैट वोंट वर्क सो पूर्व पक्ष इज कोटिंग दैट इन कर्मकांड यू हैव सच विधि Niyamas, such niyama is there in this anushthana also. Siddhanti says that phalavashad aniyamaha, meaning the kamya is being done by the upasaka because he wants a particular phala. So upasana has a vishishta phala, there is no avishishta phala. Purvapakshi can also be saying as to what Vrihi, there may be some options. Instead of Vrihi, what you can offer? You can offer either Vrihi or Yava. So somewhere there are options also seen. So that way also there is a Niyama Siddhi. Just because instead of Vrihi you can offer Yava, you cannot go and offer Dadi. So that can also be the mind of the Purvapakshi. He says there is some Niyama. So you either do this or you do that. यू कैनॉट डू अ थर्ड, यू कैनॉट से दैट आई ऑफर दधी बिकॉज व्रीही एंड यवा इज मिसिंग और आई फील लाइक ऑफरिंग दधी. दैट कैनॉट बी द केस. देर इज नो सच अनियम. यू कैनॉट गो बियॉन्ड द रूल्स एंड मेक यूर ओन रूल्स. सो सच काइंड ऑफ मीनिंग ऑल्सो बी रेड हियर. सिद्धांते फलवशाद अनियम. द पूर्व पक्षी इज सेइंग दैट यू हैव टू स्टिक टू वन उपासना और द अदर बिकॉज दैट्स व्हाट ही इज क्लेमिंग. विकल्पेन एव अनुष्ठेयत्वम एज पर अर्लियर अधिकरण. बट सिद्धांती सेज इट इज नॉट सो. फला इज डिफरेंट इन काम्य प्रतीक उपासनाज. द फलाज ऑफ डिफरेंट उपासनाज आर डिफरेंट. देयरफॉर फलवशाद अनियम. श्रुति कैनॉट टेल यू यू शुड डिजायर ओनली दिस एंड बिकॉज श्रुति कैनॉट मेक अ नियम एज टू वॉट यू शुड डिजायर. द डिजायर कम्स अपॉन इज ऑन इट्स ओन. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन उपासकास पूर्व संस्कारास अक्रॉस जन्मास. ही मे और मे नॉट वर्क ऑन दोज डिजायर्स. दैट फ्री विल ही हैज. हाउएवर द श्रुति कैनॉट से यू यू हैव टू डिजायर दिस. ही कैनॉट डिजायर समथिंग अदर देन वॉट ही हैज संस्कारास ऑफ. So if the upasaka wants to be a grihastha and wants to do karma, in some karmas, in most karmas, in fact for a grihastha, in most kamya karmas, you should have a putra. Kamya karmas cannot be done by a, in fact kamya karmas which are shrauta, these cannot be done by brahmacharis. It has to be done by a grihastha. So when a grihastha is getting married, a brahmachari is getting married and becoming grihastha, he is entering grihastha ashrama only for dharma. There is no other reason to enter as per the shastra. Now why should he beget a child, especially a putra? Because he wants to do kamya karma. For kamya karma he should have a putra. In fact for other karmas also, to become a temple priest also, actually a shrestha temple priest is one who is a grihastha and has a son, because karma adhikara is only for the son, not for the daughter. There is a benefit in getting the daughter also. It is not that only a putra should be desired, putri should also be desired, because kanyadana has a great punya that will also give sukha to the parents. So therefore parents should not only desire a putra so that they can continue the karma and get kamya phalas, they should also desire and beget a daughter so that they can do kanyadana and get punya which cannot be gotten by any other means. By no amount of dana or by any vaidika karma can one get such punya that one gets by kanyadana. So it is not there is no discrimination as such, but particular things can be done by a particular set of dravyas or sadhanas. There is no option there. You have to follow the rules as per the scriptures. So now vrihyadishu eva anushthana niyama siddhi being there, one can pick one upasana and stick to it, says the Purvapakshi. Siddhante phalavashad aniyama. Since there cannot be a rule saying that this is the phala that you should seek for desire, you should desire this kind of a phala, even if the Shruti says one has to work on it, but then one cannot say that I don't want this while having such desires. He has to work on them, and when the desire is stronger and he is unable to get, one is unable to get it through laukika means, then the alaukika upayas are given by the Shruti. So then such upasanas can be followed and more than one can be put together. Siddhante phalavashad aniyamaiti phalabhedaha. Yascha pratikopastayaha nama brahma ityupasita ityadikaha tasu kim vikalpaha uta yathakama anushthanam iti vishaye vikalpayeva iti purvapaksha. So we saw this with respect to the pratikopasanas which are there. Yascha pratikopasanas. Those pratika upasanas which are there, upasti is strilinga, therefore yaha in plural, yaha cha pratika upastayaha strilinga in प्लूरल मीन्स उपासनाज विद्या सच एज वॉट नाम ब्रह्म इत्युपासीत सो दिस इज द मैनर नाम इज ब्रह्म इन दिस मैनर यू डू द उपासना इट विल हैव अ पर्टिकुलर काम्य फल तासु किम विकल्प सो इज देयर अ विकल्प यू पिक वन एंड स्टे विथ इट उत यथा कामम अनुष्ठानम इति विषय यथा कामम इन कीपिंग विथ योर डिजायर यू हैव मोर डिजायर्स देन यू डू मोर उपासनाज When such a doubt comes up, vishaye sati vikalpaye vaiti purvapaksha. Purvapaksha says you stick with one, just like in the ahangra upasana as claimed by the siddhanti. Siddhantastu kamyastu adrushtadvara phalahetavaha vidyaha yatha kam samuchyeran van nava samuchyeran. Siddhanti says you can do multiple samuchaya of multiple upasanas or you can stick to one vikalpa. You can stick to one option. Why? Because all these kamya upasanas are what? They are phalahetava vidya. These are upasanas which are hetu for phala. They will result in phala. How? Adrushta dvara. Through adrushta. There may be some drushta phala also, but adrushta phala is the main result of the उपासनाज विच यू विल गेट लेटर सो यू कीप ऑन डूइंग मोर यू विल एक्यूमुलेट ऑल दैट टू बी डिलीवर्ड लेटर वेन एवर द कर्मा इज राइट फॉर फ्रक्टिफिकेशन यू गेट इट इन दैट जन्म सो यू कीप ऑन एक्यूमुलेटिंग नाउ कुतः वाई सो पूर्व हेतु अविशिष्ट फलत्वस्य विकल्प प्रयोजकस्य अत्र अभावात् इत्यर्थः So earlier hetus which were given by the Siddhanti in the case of Ahangra Upasanas, that hetu is missing, earlier hetu. Which was that hetu? Avishishta phala. As to Ahangra Upasanas, multiple Ahangra Upasanas, different Ahangra Upasanas, not multiple, various different Ahangra Upasanas in methodologies end up with the same result. That is Avishishta. So you can do one. Why do you want to do more when you can get the same result by whichever upasana is ishta? And that was the hetu for what? Vikalpa prayojaka. It was vikalpa prayojaka. It was leading to vikalpa. The analysis was leading to vikalpa because if more than one upasanas also give the same result or if there are upasanas, five upasanas, U1, U2, U3, U4, U5, all of them individually give the same result, you can do whichever one you want. So that is the vikalpa prayojaka because all U1 to U5, all upasanas have avishishta phala, same result, therefore they will become vikalpa prayojaka. That hetu. So all the upasanas will giving the same result. It's like, you know, going to the shop, five people are yelling out and saying, oh, you come to our shop, you come to our shop. Whatever you want, I have. So if it is really true, whatever you want, all the five shops have, you can go to any shop. Why should you go to multiple shops? So it is like shopping. When you are window shopping for upasanas, you can pick one and stick to it, said the Siddhanti in case of Ahangra upasanas. Here that Atra abhavat, that hetu is missing, therefore vikalpa prayojaka hetu, avishishta phala missing, there is vishishta phala, whichever vishesha you want, that kind of kamya vishesha being the phala of various upasanas, you can do those various upasanas in keeping with what? The kama, yatha kama. Purvam yatha pratikopastinam swatantratvad yatha kama manushthanam. न तथा इह अहंग्राश्रित उपास्तीनां अंगतंत्रत्वात् इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्या इदमाह सो द वे इन द अर्लियर अधिकरण द प्रतीक उपासनाज आर स्वतंत्र दे आर स्वतंत्रत्वात् सो अर्लियर उपासनाज बीइंग इंडिपेंडेंट विच वंस प्रतीक उपासनाज काम्य उपासनाज देर इज अ यथा कामम यथा काम यथेच्छा अनुष्ठान हाउ एवर अंगाश्रित उपासनास सो विच आर दी उपासनास वी हैव सीन अहंग्र उपासनास विच वॉज डेल्ट विथ दी डेल्ट विथ इन दी वन अधिकरण बैक टू दी करेंट अधिकरण एंड इन दी लास्ट अधिकरण वी सॉ प्रतीक उपासनास नाउ दी पूर्वपक्षी इज टेकिंग दिस प्रतीक उपासना कंक्लूजन एंड सेइंग हाउ यू हैव इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ उपासनास प्रतीक उपासनास बिकॉज दे हैव इंडिपेंडेंट रिजल्ट्स दे आर नॉट द सेम रिजल्ट एंड देयर फॉर यथा कामम यथेच्छा अनुष्ठानम इट इज द डिजायर इज डिफरेंट फॉर डिफरेंट उपासकास एंड डिफरेंट उपासकास कैन कंबाइन और डू इट इंडिविजुअली दे कैन स्टिक टू वन विकल्प और समुच्चय इधर समुच्चयन नवा समुच्चयन सो नवा समुच्चयन मीन्स मे यू टेक इट एज अ विकल्प सो यू कैन डू समुच्चय ऑल्सो यू कैन कीप इट एज अ विकल्प ऑल्सो इट इज बेस्ड ऑन यूर डिजायर यू डिसाइड सेज द श्रुति टू द उपासकास बिकॉज ऑफ वेराइटी ऑफ उपासकास एंड वाई वेराइटी बिकॉज डिजायरेबल डिजायर्स कैन नॉट बी द सेम अक्रॉस देर आर डिफरेंस इन डिजायर्स डिजायर्ड न तथा यह एंड नाउ वी आर लुक एट अंगाश्रित उपासनास वॉट आर अंगाश्रित उपासनास कर्म हैज सम कर्मांगास बेस्ड ऑन दिस कर्मांगास देर इज उपासनास विच कैनॉट बी डन इंडिपेंडेंटली दे आर टू बी डन विद द कर्म देर इज नो देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ डूइंग कर्म ओनली सो कर्म विद इट्स अंग ओनली मीनिंग कर्म अंग सहित अंग हैज सी अंगाज आर दोज विच डू नॉट हैव मेन इंडिपेंडेंट फला The angas have to be done. They are satellite karmas, subsidiary karmas, which together with the main primary angi karma will give the result, the mukhya phala. Without them, the mukhya phala will not be there. There will be depletion in the result. Adrushta will be less. Therefore, anga karma should be done. There is no choice of doing only angas. Main karma has to be done. Main karma has to be done, angas also should be done. But if some angas are missing, there will be lesser result. Anga upasanas by themselves cannot give you much of anything without the primary main karma, angi. So, anga, angi, bhava, wherever there is in the karma, those have to be done. So, if you do only karma, meaning karma along with its primary karma along with anga, what the Shruti says that you will get Dakshinayana Marga and Pitruloka. So Pitruloka is also a part of Swarga only because it is Sukhakaraka. However, the stay is not as long as it is in Swarga. Similarly, Swargaloka is also Sukhakaraka. However, it is not as long and fulfilling or gives as much Sukha and so much long time sukha as higher loka. So every higher loka with higher upadhi will give more happiness for a longer duration. Therefore the karmi seeks more and more higher upadhis and more higher lokas. More and more high lokas. So higher lokas. So devata upadhi, devaloka, ityadi. So on from chandraloka which is considered as pitruloka, one wants higher and higher. The highest being Brahmaloka. For Brahmaloka prapti, one has to do upasanas along with the karmas. Only karmas are not sufficient. So grahastha who is doing upasanas, who is doing karmas, should also do upasanas if he wants higher phala. However, if he does not do upasanas, it does not mean that he will not get the karma phala. Karma phala will be there. Main karma phala he will anyway get if he does karma and its angas. However, the upasanas, if he does, he gets more phala, which is vishesha, and it can lead to brahmaloka. There are some independent upasanas also which have no connection to karma, which we already seen in pratika upasanas or earlier ahangra upasanas. Ahangra upasana can also give brahmaloka. So there is a setup as to which upasana can be done independently and what is the phala? Which upasana can be done independently and thereby some kamya phala can be there? And which upasanas are tied to कर्मास एंड दे हैव टू बी डन विद दी कर्मा टू गेट ब्रह्मलोक का काइंड ऑफ फला, विदाउट विच कर्मा विल गिव टू रिजल्ट इन इन दी पितृलोक, रिजल्ट इन स्टे इन पितृलोक, सच काइंड ऑफ पितृ उपाधि. सो ऑल दीज नियमाज आर देर. सो पूर्व पक्षी सेज न तथा यह अंगाश्रित उपास्ती नाम किम न स्वतंत्र नास्ती इत्यर्थ. स्वातंत्र नास्ती, देर इज नो स्वतंत्रता इन दीज अंगाश्रित उपासना. वाय अंगतंत्रत्वाद. सो देर इज नो इंडिपेंडेंस इन दीज उपासना अंगतंत्रत्वाद इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्या. सो ही इज गिविंग इट एज अ, जस्ट लेट मी चेक वेदर इट इज रियली पूर्व पक्षी हियर. ओके सो देर आर ऑल्सो सम उपासनास, एक्चुअली वी हैव सीन दिस एज वेल, वी हैव सीन दी उपासनास, सम उपासनास विच हैव कर्म दृष्टि, मीनिंग कर्म काइंड ऑफ अंगाज इन द उपासना इटसेल्फ, which we have seen earlier. They are, we had seen some upasanas which are in the proximity of the karmas, but they are not ashrita in the sense that they are not anga to the, they are ashrita on the karma anga, but they are not karma angas or karma anga angas themselves. So that is the difference here. Karma anga ashrita upasanas, anga ashrita upasanas, they are not themselves angas. When they are the angas, then they should be done along with the karma. But when they are karma anga ashrita upasanas, they don't have samuchaya, meaning the upasanas are in the karma kanda section or in proximity to it, because there are many a step in the upasanas which are similar to the karma. So you have to imagine these. For example, when you go from कर्मकांडा टू दी उपनिषद, देन दी उपासनाज विच आर दी प्राइमरी पर्पस ऑफ दी उपनिषद इज टू गिव ज्ञान, दैट ज्ञान इज कंप्लीटली इंडिपेंडेंट, इट हैज एब्सोल्युटली नो इंडिपेंडेंट इन सेंस देर इज नो समुच्चय पॉसिबल ऑल्सो, इवन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू समुच्चय, द समुच्चय इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज वन हैज टू गिव अप कर्म टू डू टू फॉलो ज्ञान प्रॉपर. You cannot ride two horses. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says it clearly that one cannot ride two horses which are going not only tangentially, not same direction, not the tangent also, on a tangent, they are going on opposite sides. They are running on opposite sides. One cannot ride it. To ride karma and jnana together is like riding such two horses. So orthodoxy says that one has to give up karma, सर्वकर्म परित्याग सर्वकर्म संन्यास फॉर ज्ञान टू फ्रक्टिफाई कंप्लीटली. सो दैट इज द ऑर्थोडॉक्सी देर, बट वन हैज टू रीच देर. हाउ डू यू रीच देर? फॉर सो द सेटअप इज दैट कर्मकांड गिव्स चित्त शुद्धि व्हेन द काम्य आर ड्रॉप्ड एंड ओनली नित्य कर्मास आर डन. देन व्हाट अबाउट द उपासनास? उपासनास गिव चित्त एकाग्रता एंड देर इज अनुग्रह ऑफ द देवता which blesses one to go from karmakanda via upasanas into jnanakanda proper. So when this is the setup, then the upasanas have to help a person switch from karma buddhi, karmi, being karmi, to jijnyasu. So for that to happen, it is not easy for anyone to give up karma, because for As a grihastha, one would have done karma starting from brahmacharya ashrama to seeing the grandchild, actually till one sees grandchild, considering a regular setup, not the vairagya janya sannyasa or jidnyasa. There is no such niyama, one can walk out anytime. However, if one is with a tivra vairagya, when that is lacking, then the normal setup is that, you know, first like a 100-year life, 25 years brahmacharya, then next 25 years grihastha ashrama, and one can go to vanaprastha, or one should go to vanaprastha in the non kali yuga. In kali yuga such that niyama is not there, but earlier, in before kali yuga, the niyama was that when one sees the face of the firstborn or actually the grandson, then one has to walk off into the forest. Nowadays there is nothing called as a forest. So Vanaprastha Ashrama. And then do upasanas, etc. Only upasanas, with or without karmas, mostly without karmas, with or without patni also. And then in the last, after 75, whatever their niyama may not be there, because vairagya, it will result in ekagrata vairagya, one can move on to sannyasa. So that being a setup, karmi cannot move to upasanas directly, meaning to jnana directly or to shuddha upasana directly, because he is used to doing karma. In fact, those who take to sannyasa and are used to such karma, they miss their yajnopavita. Yajnopavita is given up. They miss their yajnopavita. They miss their daily sandhya vandana, and those who are doing agnihotra, they miss their agnihotra also. They feel very, like a retired person who is a workaholic misses. One fine day he is retired, he is sitting at home, he has an entire day to fill up, he has nothing to do. It drives him mad. So similarly, Karmakandi will also be driven mad if he goes to jnana directly. Therefore, the Shruti helps by giving upasanas which are karmanga ashrita. So these upasanas find the place in the beginning of the, if you look at Chandogya also, initial upasanas are all, or Taittiriya also, initial upasanas are the Shikshavalli. They are based on the aksharas that one is chanting. Here in Chandogya, you will see upasanas which are based on the Sama ityadi, Udgitam upasita, Nama Brahma ityupasita. All these upasanas that we see later, they are in Kamya also. So, in similar sections, you will find of Karma Kanda, you will find upasanas which are based on the karmanga. They are not themselves karmanga, but they are based on the karma anga. If you have done the karma right, then you remember these angas, and if you remember these angas, then you can do the upasanas easily. And then after these upasanas, slowly one will be taken to different kind of upasanas, and then to ahangra upasana, and further to Nirguna Brahma Upasana, and then to Jnana Kanda, Nirguna Brahma Jnana. So this is a gradation in upasanas, or stepping stones. These are the stepping stones leading to Jnana. So therefore, Puram Yatha Pratika Upasana Svatantratvad Yatha Kama Manushthanam Na Tatha Iha Angashrita Upasthinam Angatantratvad. Angatantratvad, Atantra here is the dependency, Ashraya, Anga. Angas are tantra, angas are the ashraya, they will drive the upasanas. Therefore, pratyudharana sangatya idamaha, Purvapakshi says that there is a dependency of these upasanas on the angas, therefore samuchaya should be done. These upasanas are not swatantra. So you cannot say you do samuchaya, you may not do samuchaya, such kind of a samuchaya or vikalpa option is not there, as like the earlier adhikarana. And there is no vikalpa alone also, like the ahangra upasanas, which have gone back two adhikaranas back compared to the upcoming adhikarana. Yathashre bhava adhikaranam angeshu yathashre bhavaha. So Purvapakshi sutras, there are multiple Purvapakshi sutras here. Angeshu yathashre bhava, because just let me jump ahead and see. Evam Purvapakshe Siddhantaha. So Siddhant Sutra is in 65th. Therefore, whatever has gone by earlier is all Purvapakshe Sutra. So there are some 61 to 64 are some four Purvapakshe Sutras in Yathashraya Bhava Adhikaranam. Purvapakshe says Angeshu Yathashraya Bhavaha. Angeshu Yathashraya Bhavaha. So in the Angas, what is the Bhava? Yathashrayaha. Yatashre bhava, yatashreyattvam. Yatashre bhava, yatashreyattvam. So whatever is the, what is the bhava? Angeshu, vishaya saptami, with respect to angas, there is yatashre bhava. One has to follow based on the ashraya. The ashraya is the anga, and this upasana, based on that, will become an anga as well. Yathashraya bhava. The way the angas, karmangas have dependency on the primary karma, these upasanas will also have ashraya, ashri bhava. They will also become anga to the angas of the karma. So that kind of a thinking is there. Pura Pakshi presents this. So how you have to do samuchaya of the karmangas with the primary karma? Similarly, the karmanga ashrita upasanas will also have anushthana samuchaya with the karma karmangas. Atra Pura Pakshi samuchaya anushthanat phala bahulyam. What will you get? Pura Pakshi says you will get lot of phala. It's a fact that upasanas being done with karma will give you more phala. But not doing upasanas will not give you phala is not the case. Pura Pakshi is claiming samuchaya. And that is not true with all sorts of upasanas. Only where there is anga angi bhava, there is such niyama as to samuchaya has to be done. However, Pura Pakshi is claiming that all upasanas which are karmanga ashrita, they are to be done based on the steps in the karma. You can imagine them. That is what was discussed and established, argued by the Purva Pakshi, by the Siddhanti. We have seen that Siddhanti had argued that the reason they are there in the karma kanda, these upasanas, although independent, they are there in the karma kanda because the steps of karma kanda are there in the upasana. You have to imagine. And for one to imagine, if they are close to the karma, you watch them over, you do the karma, and then you pick those steps up, you can imagine them easily without the karma, without being in the place of the karma taking place, you can sit in your, in a place where there is ekanta also, and without any of the samagris of the karma, you can do the upasanas, you can do kalpana. Because that kalpana has to be vivid. As detailed is the upasana, that focused you will be, and that much of this of success will be there in the upasanas. Therefore, they are placed in close proximity to the karma, but they don't have dependency on the karma. That was the Siddhanta. So, Siddhanta yatha kama manushthanat prayoga saukaryam iti phalabheda. There is only prayoga saukaryam, yatha kama. If you want to do the upasanas, you want that phala, you do it. Otherwise, you don't do it. You just do the karma and be done with it. So, it is in close proximity. It helps you, this prayoga, it helps you to do the anushthana easily based on your own ichcha. If you want to do it, you learn from the karma and then you do the upasana separately, or you may not do. Iti phalabheda, yascha karmaanga udgita ashritaha vidyaha tasu samuchyena eva anushthanam uta yatha kamam iti vishaye purva paksha angeshu yathashraya bhavaha yathashraya. He explains that. So purva pakshi says when there is a vikalpa, when there is a samshaya vishaya, when there is a doubt as to what, whether the karma anga upasana, such as what udgita ityadi, udgita upasana, udgita is karma anga, sama anga, in that udgita there is omkara. In that omkara, you do udgita buddhi. So, udgitam upasita, om iti udgitam upasita. So, this ashrita upasanas, vidyas, regarding them what? Tasu samuchyene varushthanam uta yathakamam iti vishaye. When there is a doubt as to, you have to do this upasana along with the karma, there is a samuchya, you have to do them together, or yathakamam. So, you may not do karma, you may just do upasana. One may give up the karma and do upasana. Not all karmas, only that particular karma one can give up also and do only upasana. Is it possible or not? When such doubt is there, Purva Paksha is what? Angeshu yathashraya bhava. Yathashraya bhava. The way there is ashraya ashraya sambandha in the anga anga angi of the karma, similarly there is ashraya ashraya bhava in the upasanas and the karmangas. Yatha kratushu ashritanam anganam samuchitya anushthana niyamaha. What is the vidhi? Rule is that the ashrita angas of the angi karma हु इज द आश्रय, द आश्रय इज द कर्म, मेन कर्म, प्राइमरी कर्म. द अंगाज आर आश्रित, वेर आर द आश्रित, दे आर आश्रित इन कर्म, प्राइमरी कर्म. सो द अंगी कर्म इज द आश्रय फॉर द अंग कर्मास विच आर आश्रित इन देम, एंड देयर फॉर वॉट समुचित्य अनुष्ठान नियम. The anusthana says that angas cannot be done independently. You have to do with the primary karma. Tatha angeshu ashritanam upastinam ashraya bhava. So yatha ashraya bhava means similarly these upasanas which are karmanga ashritas, they are angatantra. They are dependent on the anga of the karma. Therefore you cannot give up the anga of the karma. You have to do with the anga of the karma, and anga anyway cannot be cannot be done independently. Anga cannot be without the angi. Therefore, you have to do the angi karma, you have to do the anga karma, and then you have to do the anga ashrita upasanas together. So, samuchitya anushthana niyama is the result. So, ashraya bhava means what? Samuchitya anushthana niyama eva ityartha. You cannot do them independently, says the Purvapakshi. Nanu tarhi godonasya api samuchyaye niyamasya adityatah. Then the Siddhanti asks. So the Siddhanti is the Purvapaksha to the Purvapakshi. Siddhanti says, in that case, Godhana, we have seen where there is a vikalpa, there is an option given. Yatha kama. If you are someone who wants more pashu, then godahanena pashukamasya. So one who wants pashu should use this chamasa patra is where you have water. So in the karma, where you keep the water is your chamasa patra. But then if you want pashu, as a result you want pashu is a dhana. In the old era, pashu is a dhana. So if you want more cows, more cattle, then what should you do? While doing the karma, you do the same karma. But instead of your regular chamasa patra, which is different from the godohana patra, where you milk the cow, you use the same godohana, the vessel in which you milk the cow, you use that as your chamasa patra to hold water. Thereby, everything else is same. What you have done is that because you are Pashukama, you have used the Godohana Patra as your Chamasa, and thereby it is an option. There is no Niyama. But if you say that Angashrita Upasanas, says the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi, if you claim that Angashrita Upasana has dependency of Samuchaya, has dependency in the Anga, and therefore all of these should be done together, then, and you consider it as a vidhi, niyama, yatha samuchitya anushthana niyama, then there will be samuchaya niyama in what? Samuchitya anushthana niyama in godhavana patra also. Godhavana patra should be used. This is the vidhi, niyama, that will be the mimamsa result. Ityataha. So we will look at the response of the Purvapakshi in the next part. We already jumped the gun. संसिद्धम आदिमध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनम पूर्णमात्म ज्योतिरुपास्महे. नमस्ते. धन्यवाद.
धन्यवाद. नमस्ते.